Hey everyone, I'm continuing the video series on low frequency 125 kHz RFID with the Flipper Zero. This video is going to focus on the T5577 key fob, which is a programmable 125 kHz RFID device. Be sure to join my Discord server for giveaways and for more conversation about the Flipper Zero. Let's get started. People are always asking about what firmware they should use. And the T5577 support is one area where the firmwares are different. The official firmware supports writing to the T5577 fob. Unleashed firmware adds the concept of setting a password for the T5577. Unleashed can also clear the password. Extreme firmware has all of the features from Unleashed, and it adds the ability to read and emulate raw RFID. Roguemaster firmware has all the features of Extreme and adds the ability to write data blocks to the T5577. If you see a lock icon next to a setting, you need to go to Settings, System Debug, and turn it on. For today's video, I'll be using Roguemaster. I'll start with the demo. We've read in the HID card, you can see with the pass light. And now we've written to the T5577. You can see the card number is 29649 that we cloned onto our T5577. And you can see that the reader sent the card number 29649. Next, I'll use the card 29650. We'll read that with our flipper. And then we'll try to use our flipper to write it to our T5577. It says, make sure the card is writable and not protected. The writable means that the lock bit's not set, and the protected means there's no password. You can see we have a lock icon. So we'll exit the application. We'll go up into settings. And then we'll go into System, and then we'll go down to Debug, and we'll turn it on. This enables all the debug settings, but the problem is now we no longer have a lock warning of dangerous operations. I don't know the password, so I'll just hit Save. And then we hit Start, and it's using the 124 default passwords to unlock the T5577. If you used a custom password, you'd have to enter it on the previous screen. Now we'll go back and read that 650 card. There it is. And then we'll go ahead and try to write that back to our T5577 tag. And now let's validate the data was written. And we can see the card is 29650, so we rewrote the tag. Low frequency RFID is typically called LF-RFID or 125 kHz RFID, but sometimes it's also just RFID on the flipper. Captured files are saved in the SD card in the LF-RFID folder. The LF-RFID.c file has all the passwords we use to unlock the T5577 card. The RFID reader sends out a 125 kHz signal. When the tag is near the reader, the coil in the reader and the coil in the tag are coupled. The tag uses the signal to get power, so there's no battery. Once the tag is charged, it applies various loads across the coil, which are detected by the receiver. The tag keeps repeating its data signal while it's in the field of the receiver. The Flipper Zero supports multiple modulations like FSK2A and PSK, speeds like RF50 and RF64, and different data block sizes. In this video, we're using the H10301, which has three data blocks, versus the EM4100, which has two data blocks. I wanted to take a moment to briefly look at the user data from a H10301 tag. We'll dive into more details in a future video. At the top left, we see part of the data stream of the facility code. This is where we're sending the bits 101. Our data rate has a divisor of 50, and our modulation is FSK2A, which means it varies the frequency and the amplitude of the signal. When we're sending a 1, it's slower and it's a larger amplitude, and when we're sending a 0, it's faster and a smaller amplitude. In the graph, we're just zoomed in to 3 bits being sent, but the full data stream is much larger. Each user data block is 32 bits. You can see the data stream for the facility code, and we've highlighted the part from the graph. This transmitted sequence of 0 and 1s are then further interpreted into bits. For the H10301, we skip every other bit. This results in 75 hex or 117 decimal. Our flipper 0 then shows us the facility code of 117. This is the memory layout of the T5577. When the tag is near the reader, it starts repeating the user data using the configured data rate and modulation that's set in block 0. This allows the T5577 to emulate many different types of LF-RFID cards. The password in block 7 is about protecting the T5577 user data blocks from modification. The tag itself and the original LFRFID tag send out its data immediately and do not require any password. RogueMaster is working on a RTF, reader talks first, which may mean in the future there are some tags that need to be authenticated first. We saw block 0 is the configuration data block. All of the low-frequency RFID protocols the flipper supports use basic mode except for carry. So in this video, we'll be looking at basic mode. So this is the 32 bits used for that configuration block 0. And then there's a 33rd bit, which is in each block, there's a lock or if it's not locked. If you put locked, you will not be able to change this data later. So we always write a 0 there for the flipper. And then the master key, the flipper typically writes zeros. So 0, 0, 0, 0. And then we have 0, 0, 0, 0. And then 0, 0, 0. And then for the data rate, we want to use RF50. And so that's 1, 0, 0. And then 0 for basic mode. And then our modulation, we want to use FSK2A, so that's 00111. And then PSKCF, we're not using PSK, so go 00. And AOR is whether or not it needs to reply as soon as it's in the field or not. So we want to set that to 0 so that it instantly answers. And then bit 24 is 0. We have 3 blocks of data, so that's 011 in binary. We do not want to set a password, so we'll set that to 0. And then the last 4 bits, the flipper sets to 0, so 0000. And so you can see over here in hex, our value is 00107060. Had we set the password bit to 1, it would have ended in 70 instead of 60. So that represents the configuration block for H10301. I'll wipe the existing T5577. There's no password, so I'll say yes, I'm sure. And go ahead and erase and start. So this is going to erase the chip, so there's no data on any of the blocks. Next, we'll try to read the card again. And we'll make sure that since there's no data, we shouldn't be able to read any information off the card. And then next, we'll set that configuration data. We'll write that data to block 0. So we're not protected. And again, the value we calculated was 0010706 0. And so this is for RF50 FSK2A in 3 blocks of data, selected on block 0. Okay, and we're writing that block. In a future video, we'll talk about data blocks, but for now, in block one, we want to write the value 1D555955, and this is for a H10301 format. We'll write that to block one. And then in block two, we'll write 5569A999. And that's for our FC equals 117. And we'll write that to block two. And then in block three, we'll write 5556566 for card number 142. And again, that's page 0, block 3. And now that we've written our configuration block 0 and our three data blocks, we'll go to read ASK. And there's our card. FC is 117 and the card's 142. And our configuration block is RF50FSK2A3 blocks. So in this video, we just learned how to create the data for block 0, but in a future video, we'll look at the user data blocks as well. Next, let's look at the set clear T5577 custom password. We'll go ahead and say we want to set the password, and I'll use a password of 11112222. We'll go ahead and hit save. We don't want a lock bit, so choose no. We don't want the password to have the lock bit, so no. We want our master key to be zeros, so say no. And then we'll go ahead and start. So it's writing our password to block 7. And block 0 is 148050. So that's bad news because it just changed our modulation and our data rate. So this feature will only work with EM4100 tags. As you can see, now that our modulation and data rate's wrong in the config block, our tag is no longer being read. So we'll cancel that. We'll go ahead and clear the password. And again, that password was 11112222. We'll say no, and then no, and then no. And we'll go ahead and start that. And it's setting block 7 to zeros and 148040 for our config block. So the good news is it's cleared the password. The bad news is our config block is still wrong. It should be 107060, but instead it's assuming an EM tag. So it's using 148040. So we can go ahead and do a write to our configuration block. So the tag's not protected anymore. 107060. And we need to save that into page 0 and then block 0. So use other until you see 0. There you go. And then we always say no and start. And now it's writing that configuration. And then we'll read the card again with our updated config block. And there it is. So the last thing we'll do is we'll go ahead and save that file. I'll just name it H. And then once it's saved, we'll go ahead and back out to the main menu. Then we'll load the save file. And then we'll do write and set password. 11112222. And then hit save. And this time it wrote the config block using 107070, which is the correct value. Our tag is now protected with the password, but it has the correct modulation and data rate. Using read ASK, we're also able to still read the tag. Now you know all about the T5577. Please like and subscribe. In a future video, we'll look at how to calculate the user data blocks like we did the configuration data block.